populism versus prudence. That's the big debate tonight, and I'm joined by K.S. Pandyarajan of the ADMK. He's also a candidate with the party. He joins us from Chennai. Thanks very much indeed, sir. Also joining us from Chennai is Manu Sundaram of the DMK, spokesperson, as well as Mr. Krishnamurthy, T.S. Krishnamurthy, former chief election commissioner. Thank you all so much for being with us. Now, Pandyarajan, look, we understand the need for subsidies in states across India, and Tamil Nadu has done an excellent job as far as the PDS is concerned, as far as insurance is concerned. But this kind of rampant handout culture is not just, some believe, bankrupting the state, but also corrupting the voter. And do you think that it's time to put an end to it, particularly by the ADMK?
No, my point of view on this is this.
Why not?
Direct transfer of assets to the poor is considered to be the most effective way to lift people out of poverty, whether it's a fan, mixie, grinder, or whether it is the free goats and sheep and cow, as you call them. We believe that, you know, if in Tamil Nadu there's been a strong measure of lifting people out of the poverty line.
Laptops,
the whole of India, you have 26% poverty, people under.
No, but we're talking now about laptops,
which are really developmental schemes and not purely welfare.
Where does it end?
No, no, cell phones, listen, the cell phones are only
for. You call them developmental schemes. You call them developmental schemes. What Mr. Gopal Swami, former election commissioner, called it, he said that the politician in Tamil Nadu, he said, is corrupting the voter.
Not really. I think in none of these schemes that you pointed out, I think you did a good job of covering the entire range of subsidized or free given kind of products and services. And all of it adds up to about 1/3 of the state budget. In a budget of 1,66,000 crores, the last budget we did, it's about roughly 30% going into all these schemes, including the subsidy for food, which we give here. But don't forget that 2/3 of the budget is going into purely developmental schemes. This is a state which has very successfully turned the power deficient situation to a power surplus situation.
Okay.
7,500 megawatts have been added to the grid in the last 5 years.
Before you start listing all the achievements of the ADMK, let me turn to the DMK. Can I just make you pause there for just a second, Pandyarajan, and bring in Manu Sundaram? Manu Sundaram, some say that it was the DMK which started this entire competitive race for freebies in 2006 when you brought in the free TV scheme. That year we calculated that term of the DMK ended up spending almost 21,000 crores on similar handouts. And now your manifesto, rather than try and correct some of this, is actually adding more. You're saying instead of Amma kitchens which serve subsidized meals, you're going to serve a free meal a day at Anna kitchens, named after Anna Durai. You're going to increase the amount of gold and the amount that's given as marital benefits. Are both of you, as I said earlier, pushing the state to both an economic precipice as well as degrading its politics and its voters?
Right. Vasu, before we launch into this freebies discussion, you know, I just wanted to make one quick point on what you had quite aptly described as the two-state system in Jayalalitha's Salem rally today, which I thought looked more like a theater of megalomania. And specifically, I know that NDTV was not allowed to cover that event live. And that's probably because of the inhuman conditions there, where two people were reported dead from attending the rally, and where at least you know, a few acres of crop land has been converted into a temporary helipad so
that
he could come by helicopter and go back. So coming back to what you had asked about the freebies,
I agree.
Quite important. But I also think, I mean, the lives of two people who attended a rally today also requires some sort of mention on this television show. See, specifically, the issue of freebies has been dealt with quite exhaustively by the Supreme Court in the Subramanian Balaji versus the state of Tamil Nadu. It's a two-judge bench order. I mean, there's not a great deal we can go in. It definitely doesn't qualify as a corrupt practice according to the Supreme Court. It does not come under Section 123 of the Representation of People Act, which talks about corrupt practice.
it's
speaking
it's,
about what
right.
the DMK has offered
right.
in this election.
Manu, if I can just Manu. Yes. Manu, if I can just say that you're right when you say that the Supreme Court did not construe these freebies as illegal, but they did also say in that same judgment that it does shake the roots of a democratic practice. So it did raise concerns about them.
Right, and they've also given they've prescribed how we can, you know, rectify this, and they've asked the Election Commission to issue a direction to political parties, when they come up with an election manifesto, have to share the details with the Election Commission, and also describe the ways and means as to how these schemes would be funded, which we've done. But specifically about the DMK's manifesto for the 2016 elections, which you touched upon, there are a couple of free things which we've offered to give. Let me just list them out. One is we have offered to provide free education for all first-generation learners up to professional courses. We've also included a freebie of interest-free loans to street vendors. We also said we will provide free training to 25 lakh unemployed youth who are registered with the Employment Exchange, and free bus passes for disabled.
I know this is.
We've reported this. Yes. So these are all part of an entire.
We've reported all of this, but I'm worried more about the impact of it. Can I just bring in Mr. Krishnamurthy, who's not had a chance to come in at all. Are you concerned, sir, as somebody who's both been an election commissioner, you also live in Tamil Nadu, when you see what all of this is doing to the voters of Tamil Nadu?
Well, as far as the freebies are concerned, I am fairly clear. It is not a desirable democratic practice. As far as freebies are concerned, I have another suggestion. If parties are going to give public goods like, you know, roads or a stadium or a school building, I can understand. But to specify a particular category of voters for certain benefits, it is not in consonance with the democratic spirit. I am also not very happy about the decision given in this regard by the Supreme Court. They have left it to the Election Commission to draft certain guidelines. The pity is that this is an undesirable practice which is spreading not only in Tamil Nadu but in other places. In some places very successfully, in other places not very successfully.
Yes.
But I think the sooner the voters realize that these gimmicks will not bring votes, and the candidates and the parties realize it is good for the country. As far as the individual parties are concerned, I choose not to comment.
Yes.
All that I would say is, the parties should come together and arrive at a decision not to indulge in this undesirable democratic practice, because financially it is going
to
affect the working of the government in the later period.